Previously on the Great Aussie Channel.
I'll try my best. You're a good man, Charlie McClellan.
Same to you, Dylan.
Thank you.
Hey Dylan, it's me, Charlie McClellan. If you're hearing this, I need your help, now. Dylan, can you hear me?
Self-explanatory, Mr. Neison. Detective, Yes, sir. You know, if I'm correct in speaking, you escaped prison before.
I did, a couple years back, about 4 years ago.
You explain how you did that, sir.
It's simple, mathematicians, we got a couple of, in the bins, a group of bins, we got a couple of smart guys. We put explosives on them, we blew out the walls, right?
Yes, sir.
We made our way, grabbed us a couple of ladders from around the building, you know, and we climbed out from that hole and escaped from there.
Yes, sir. Now, recently after your checkups in the prison, people, the doctors have diagnosed you with sociopathy, and what do you think of that?
It's just any other disease out there. It's not even a disease. It's a what is it, a psychological matter?
Yes, sir.
It's I don't know, man. It's just, detective, it's just a hoax, you know. It's like sociology, psychology, whatever. You're a psychopath or you're not. And when I found out the news, I thought the whole world was crumbling on me, but now I think of it as this. Listen to me well, listen to me clear. For today is another day, and another day is today, is what I kept telling myself, my people back there. You know, I figured myself out, and I thought none of this was real. This didn't matter. This world, look around you, Neeson. This world doesn't matter. It's all a hoax. What do you think about it? What are your thoughts?
Well, this world seems pretty much like I'm feeling this desk right now. This doesn't seem much like a hoax to me, sir.
Well, you should open your eyes up a little bit more. That's what I think of all that.
Yes, sir. Now, we have you in here for a couple years to the day, so after your time in prison is done, do you think you'll change your ways and be a good model citizen of the community?
You know, I think only God's will is going to say that. That power, that desire, that's up to God. That's not up to me. And is that the end of the interview?
Yeah, that's just about it. Thank you for your time, and we'll conduct this interview elsewhere. Thank you.
Doug, you there? Doug, do you copy?
Hey, Dad. It's been a while. It's been too long. It seems like only yesterday that I got the news. It's that time of year again. People are setting up the decorations for Christmas. I hope you would have been proud of the decorations I set up at my place. I think they're pretty good. I listened to one of your interviews again. You interviewed a Viper guy. Every day I strive to be like you. And I miss you. So much. There's some days I think that you're just away on one of your investigations again. And then I realize it's... And then I realize you're not coming back. Sometimes I just don't know what to do. I guess what I can do right now is just keep on doing my work, because I know that that's what you would have wanted. Sorry. I hope I make you proud, and I hope to God I get to see you again one day. Well, this factory work goes. I'll come back soon.
Dylan, you there? Dylan, do you copy?
Look, Dylan. Something doesn't feel right here. I just found this weird looking, like knife looking thing in my front lawn, and I remember seeing a guy just at my place. That kind of meshed your description of Daniel Volvo, like him, except he had a different mask, but still. It seems like something that you would know best about. Yes, sure, I can defend myself, but you know more about these kinds of things than I do, and you have the knowledge, and just, I'll even just come over here as soon as you can and deal with this. Please respond. If you hear this, please respond. Charlie McClellan, I'm with that.
Merry Christmas, Charlie McClellan.